This video is about the wave feeder inputs and outputs. So we will see what are the wave feeder controller inputs. It may be digital inputs, it may be digital output, and these may be analog inputs and outputs. We will see what are the main inputs and outputs of a wave feeder controller. First of all, we will see what are the CCR, DO and the DI of controller. This is the digital output from the CCR. First DO of the CCR and the digital input of the controller is start command. When operator gives a start command, PLC will generate a digital output and it will be digital input of the controller. Second DO of the CCR is reset. In case of any fault, operator will reset the fault and the PLC will generate a DO and this will be the input of the controller. CCR digital input may be the ready signal from the controller that everything is okay and wave feeder is ready. There may be a run feedback from the controller to show the operator that wave feeder is running. In case of any fault, controller will generate a DO which will be the fault DO, and there is a totalizer pulse for each ton or kg as per our configuration. Controller will generate a pulse to show the operator that one ton has passed. There is a CCR analog output and this is the set point of the controller that how much material we need from the wave feeder. This set point is analog 4 to 20 milliamps and this is the analog input of the controller. Analog output of the controller is the CCR AI and this is the feedback of the wave feeder that how much ton or kg passing in 1 hour. This may be 4 to 20 milliamps and this is the feedback to operator in ton per hour most of the cases. Another analog output of the controller is the input of VFD and this is 4 to 20 milliamps. This is set point to the VFD that how much speed is required to meet the set point of CCR. There is a digital output for the VFD and this is the start command for VFD to start. When operator start the wave feeder, the controller generate a start command to VFD and the motor is started. This load cell cables are connected into the controller. There is also excitation and the signal and the encoder input which is in pulses is input of the controller and this is digital input or some specific channel because these pulses are high speed pulses. So these are the main inputs and outputs of a wave feeder. First operator will give the start command and the if wave feeder is ready it will start running. If there is any fault, then after rectification operator can reset it. For each ton the controller will generate a pulse to show the operator that one ton has passed and this is the feedback 4 to 20 milliamps and encoder pulses, load cell, start command for the VFD and the analog output which is the set point of the VFD. So these are the main inputs and